Hello, folks.
No, I'm unloading.
Say what?
No.
Say what?
I was just gonna rant.
Oh, how come you're ranting? I am. Hi, folks. This is Ron coming to you from another one of Grandpa's Toy Rooms. Haven't put a video up for a couple of weeks, so I decided I ought to show you what's been going on for the last 2 weeks. And the one I really wanted to show you is gone, but this little Model 8 coupe my buddy built, and probably about 6 months' time from a rolled old-time hot rod from the East Coast. And he built this baby from the ground up. Had to make a new frame for it. Then had to try and figure out how to straighten out the body, which he proceeded to do. And you can't have enough motors in a Model A, so it has a big block sitting in it. Don't know what to tell you. It's one of them things about a hot rodder. Some of the other stuff we have in the shop, this is his Fat Boy Harley. Behind it is a Triumph Bobber that we built a couple of years ago, or maybe three, I can't remember. Probably couldn't tell you this, but he took a pristine looking Triumph and built that cool bobber out of it. We have, like swinging out here without making you too sick, we have motors lined up. This chassis right here is for my wife's 55 City two-door hardtop, which I have that basically done. The chassis done. The body for it is what's sitting up there on the trailer, waiting for me to get back to work. The 32 frame right there is one of my other buddies. There's three of us in the top here. This is one of my other buddies. It's a 32 Ford frame that he's building. And over on the other wall, we have a 27T Roadster steel body that's going on it. The little blue pickup is another project that belongs to my buddy that has the Model A coupe. And the 63 City ragtop is one that he's working on. Belongs to a guy down in New Orleans, and he sent it up here for Lou to work on it. It's got new front suspension under it now. And the main thing is that Lewis built him a beautiful 409 big block and put in a point. And I'm not sure why we're not focusing part of the time, but this thing ought to be a major hauler when it's done. Over against the wall here is one of the steel 27 Roadster bodies, which is going on that 32 frame I just showed you. And then the kid that I call him a kid, because he's only 50-some years old, but the guy that built that, or is building that, also, if I can get back here and get focused in, picked up this Plymouth a few weeks ago to build a project out of that. Gonna make a road runner out of it. And the other thing that I really wanted to show you is now gone. The guy picked it up last night. We had a 56 Chevy Nomad in here that the guy sitting down there working on his motor spent probably 2.5 to 3 weeks getting it running for the guy. We pulled it out of the guy's barn where it had been for about 5 years. And then after Lewis got it running, I spent 2 days buffing out the black and white paint, and then another day on it, hand polishing it with glass, and it just came out looking awesome. I should have come out and done this last night, because the guy picked it up last night. So, just kind of a quick, well, we'll try, instead of doing it quick, we'll try and do it just kind of careful around the inside of the shop with all the stuff sitting everywhere. We can get another little bit better view of my wife's 55 Chevy body that I tore apart probably 9 years ago. When I started on it, it was a complete car, and she told me she wanted to frame off restoration. So, that was her mistake. So, anyway, guys, this is the shop. This is where I've been for the last 2 or 3 weeks. We're going to shut it off now, and we'll try to get it.